I'm afraid of letting go. I'm afraid of everything I don't know. Trying to make it out of home.
Sometimes I get lonely. I feel lonely. I get lonely sometimes. Get a little lost in my mind. Don't know why. Sometimes I get lonely. I feel lonely. I get lonely sometimes. Don't know why we all feel lonely sometimes. Sometimes I get lonely. I feel lonely. I get lonely sometimes. Get a little lost in my mind. Don't know why.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get a free bus pass. Where you get off? That's up to you. What's going on, YouTube? It's Knox Hill, and we're back with our reaction series. So today is one of the greatest days on planet Earth. Do you know why? Because Logic has dropped his final album. And while it is very sad, it's also exciting because we have new music from the man himself to check out. Now listen, I don't care what some of these other reactors say, some of these other people on the platform, what they're doing, reacting to Logic, acting like they've been a fanboy. Listen, no, okay? Logic is from Maryland. Do you know who else is from Maryland? This guy right here. And let me tell you, man, it is a tough grind coming out of Maryland and coming out of the DMV. I mean, we have had some talent. We've had Wale come out. We've had Logic come out. We got King Los. We got YB and Cordae. There's definitely talent there, but there are so many great artists that fall through the cracks. And the thing is, as a local artist, I have to support Logic, and I have been behind him for a long time. I'm about to get in right now. All these motherfuckers wonder how. All the pretty girls love my style, and they wonder if he well endowed. On stage trying to feel my... Y'all can finish that. Tic-tac-toe, if you don't know that, you ain't been rocking with the underground Logic, man. But yeah, anyways, I've been a longtime supporter of my fellow MD artists. You gotta root for your own, man, so you know I'm gonna put on for him. You know I am excited to get to this album. As soon as I had the news, you guys didn't even have to request it because we are going to do it. So the very first track that we're gonna check out is called No Pressure. It's the intro. You know, we got the Eminem album all flipped up and all kind of messed up. So this one, I thought we'd actually start from the very beginning and kind of see where the journey takes us. But a quick note before we go any further, guys, I just saw a stat that 75% of you who watch these videos are not subscribed. So do me a favor, if you like the content, you like what I'm bringing, hit that sub button. Also, you might have thought that you subscribed, but something happened with YouTube, you're no longer subscribed, so do me a favor and just double check that. All right, Logic, No Pressure. No pressure at all, man. Let's go. It's time to step up to the plate. Let's see what you got.
Welcome to the No Pressure Program.
Oh. Yo, come on, man. You gotta love it already. You got the boom bap with the drums. You got the piano rocking. It's got such an old school raw hip hop vibe. Now this is something that Logic is known for, that he has carried and stuck with throughout his career, man. He always pays homage to the greats. He knows his history, and a lot of his style and his delivery just blends so well with that. And then at the beginning, we had the voiceover that was from Incredible True Story. It's nice. Nice little connection right there. Let's go, man. We are here for this.
Good evening. This is Logic. I'm very happy I am to be back in the United States and back on the network. Even for so short a visit as this one. Back with old friends like
No ID,
who's tonight's director, and nobody argued the point. A lot of people asked us to do it again, so it's gratifying to get the chances to do it again, so it's great.
Yo, what is that? That's classic radio broadcasting. What's the name of that actor, though? I know that voice. I know it because it always reminds me of George Orwell, 1984. But his name is, God, what is it? What is it? Oh, it's going to bother me. This is going to bother me. If somebody knows, please comment below. Damn, I know this one, too. But anyways, I love the classic sampling, right? But he's mixing it with his own story. So it's like, you know, Logic is storytelling. He does this throughout all of his albums. And shout out to No ID, one of the greatest producers in the game. You know, they had to come back and do it again.
Trying to get the chance now.
No ID.
Personally, I've never met anybody who didn't like
The Incredible True Story.
Ah, yep. What do we do? Shout out to The Incredible True Story, man. If you guys haven't heard that shit, go bump it.
It's a thriller. It's half as good as we think it is. You can call it a
classic.
Quite possibly. A little escapade of mine involving a couple of planets, which shall be nameless.
responsible. Doesn't really matter. A story doesn't have to appeal to the heart. It can also appeal to the spine.
That's a wild line, man. A story doesn't have to appeal to the heart. It can also appeal to the spine. It can shock you. You feel it deep down in your bones. It goes deeper than that.
And with two magic words.
Hey, no pressure. Never graduated, but I school him like professor. Growing up, the world always told me I was lesser. Growing up.
Never graduated, but I school him like professor. Such a smooth delivery, man. And he didn't graduate, right? He even came out in an interview and said this, like he stopped going to class. He started skipping class and he fell out. You know, he fell in. He's from a rough area of Germantown. Right? So, you know, he didn't have the best of influences around him, and his family went through hell, and he was going through poverty, and he's talked about this before. So school wasn't always his first priority, but, you know, he still was focused on the music, and as school declined, music rose for him. So gotta give him props for that.
World told me I'm like professor. Growing up, the world always told me I was lesser. Growing up, the world told me I could not address her. Gangsters put that heat to your head like a hairdresser. If you press an issue on
Gangsters put that heat to your head like a hairdresser. You know when a girl's getting her hair done and she's got the heat over it? I like that, man. But also like literal heat, like gun heat. And he's talking about growing up, he was lesser because he was half black. He was half white. The world said he couldn't address her. He was poor. Thing is how he looked, right? Like even though he's half black, he still looks more white versus Drake, who's half black and half white. So you get outcasted from that community. But then you also get outcasted from the white community because it's like you're not really white either. Like he doesn't fit in anywhere. This is Logic, man.
I could not address her. Gangsters put that heat to your head like a hairdresser. If you press an issue on a block.
Hey, Logic. Snake here. I hear you're planning world domination through a new form of Metal Gear. Well, listen to me.
Yo. Yo, can we bring this back, please? Hang on.
Hey, Logic. Snake here. I hear you're planning world domination through a new form of Metal Gear.
I want to walk away. Metal Gear Solid, man. One of my favorite games of all time. Snake. Because, like, Logic has been offered a deal with Twitch, and we know that Logic loves his game, and he's always dropping gaming references. What was the video when it was like Call of Duty, and the whole video was shot from a first-person perspective, man? That was crazy. But Logic is now, you know, giving up music. He's retiring, and he's going to focus on the gaming. He's going into Twitch now. He did a gaming YouTube channel for a while, but he struggled to juggle so many plates and keep that going. So I love the Metal Gear actual Snake's voice shouting it out. That's like a dream come true, man.
I hear you're planning world domination through a new form of Metal Gear. Well, listen to me. It won't work.
The liquor that I'm drinking got me thinking about some other shit. Feeling like I'm sinking like Titanic or some other ship.
Word
to your mothership. Boy, it's that gutter shit.
Word to your mothership. Because he's from outer space, man. He's an alien. He doesn't fit in. Got him sinking like the Titanic. We all know the story of the Titanic sinking. He's on some other shit right now. He's on his other shit. This is classic Logic, man. I like this. Let's bring these bars.
Feeling like I'm sinking like Titanic or some other ship. Words to your mothership. Boy, that's that gutter shit. Breaking down the weed to get high as Thomas and Kai. But y'all
Yo, shouting out to Thomas and Kai. Again, how many different shoutouts are we going to have to past albums and discographies? And like I said before, Logic is a storyteller. So he loves to have skits. So it was Quentin Thomas and William Kai. That's right. And they were characters. They were on the spaceship, Aquarius 3, from The Incredible True Story. Oh, I love it, man. Getting high as them. High in the spaceship, but also they would get high, you know, and just have some of these just crazy creative thoughts.
Some other shit. Feeling like I'm sinking like Titanic or some other ship. Words to your mothership. Boy, that's that gutter shit. Breaking down the weed to get high as Thomas and Kai. But y'all ain't ready for that shit. That's more like Ultra 85. Memories of powdered milk and roaches in my cereal. And my crew necks like cotton material. Never...
there was too much to process there because he shouted out Ultra 85 and I was caught up on that because that's that project that he's talked about before, but he hasn't released it yet, but he's retiring. Why is he mentioning that? Hang on. That just threw me way off. And then I missed these other crew neck bars and stuff. We got to bring this back. Come on, Logic. Don't do this to me.
I'm sinking like Titanic or some other ship. Words to your mothership. Boy, that's that gutter shit. Breaking down the weed to get high as Thomas and Kai. But y'all ain't ready for that shit. That's more like Ultra 85. Memories of powdered milk and roaches in my cereal. Praying at my crew necks like cotton material. Never had a...
Praying that my crew next, that him and the Rat Pack, man, that they're going to make it. But also, the way he said next, it can be taken as a neck, right? A crew neck, like a t-shirt. What are t-shirts made out of? Cotton, like cotton material. Oh, that's a nice little double just thrown in there, man. And listen to the delivery, right? Praying that my crew next, like cotton material. Up, and then he just sits in the pocket with it. He's so smooth with his delivery. Right? So when he delivers a punchline, a lot of times it'll fly over people's heads because you don't even realize that he's throwing punchlines out there because he just continues with the smooth flow and just coming in and out of the pocket with it. It's so nice. A shout out to Powdered Milk Cereal, man. If you ain't poor, you ain't know about that.
Crew necks like cotton material. Never had a car, that's why I hate the fucking bus. Took the 61 to Germantown and hear them guns bust. Call it static, my headphones on, it's Illmatic. On my Rosa Parks in the back, writing like B-Rabbit, how I carry.
Yo, hold up. With them guns bust, talking about the 61 to Germantown. Haven't I heard this before? Hang on.
A car, that's why I hate the fucking bus. Took the 61 to Germantown and hear them guns bust. Call it static, my headphones on, it's
Illmatic. Shout out to Nas, one of the greats. Illmatic, one of the greatest albums of all time. Shout out to Germantown as well. Maryland, baby. You know we got to represent. So he's talking about taking the 61 bus. And we have heard these lines because we broke them down in our last Logic reaction, which was months ago, his No Pressure freestyle. Ah, and it makes sense, see, because this is called No Pressure, the intro. Okay. I like that, man. He's on the bus like B-Rabbit. You guys seen the movie 8 Mile? B-Rabbit's on the back of the bus. Got his headphones in as he's writing, as he's working. Logic was in that zone, in that place.
When the Germantown and hear them guns bust, call it static. My headphones on, it's Illmatic. On my Rosa Parks in the back, writing like B-Rabbit, how I carry it. Mudder the beating and I'ma bury it.
And I also miss the Rosa Parks, because you know Rosa Parks, back in the days of segregation, when blacks had to sit at the back of the bus, whites sat at the front, and she sat at the front as a big protest. I like that, playing on the whole bus scheme, the B-Rabbit, the Rosa Parks man himself, it's cool.
Rosa Parks in the back, writing like B-Rabbit, how I carry it. Mudder the beating and I'ma bury it. Producing tracks for the underground,
nah.
Drop another number one and watch them all get mad again. Memorizing verses like the Vatican, I'm glad again. Empty the...
Why do I have to break these down? I just want to enjoy this. This is like torture to me, man. Come on, let's bring it back, because we missed bars. I just zoned out. I honestly just had a total zone out. I was in a vibe.
Phones on, it's Illmatic. On my Rosa Parks in the back, writing like B-Rabbit, how I carry it. Mudder the beating and I'ma bury it. Producing tracks for the underground like Harriet. Drop another number one and watch them all get mad again. Memorizing verses like the Vatican.
Alright, so we got shout out to the Underground Railroad, like Harriet, because he was underground. Producing tracks for the underground like Carrion. And then, oh my God, tracks for the underground. And we broke this down again too. So literally, tracks is in this very music track, but also track as in train track. And the Underground Railroad that it was called, that Harriet Tubman, who's also from Maryland. See, I was taught this because I'm from Maryland, right? Led the Underground Railroad, helped to free slaves from the South and lead them to the North. It's crazy, man. Crazy lines. Let's go.
Drop another number one and watch them all get mad again. Memorize the verses like the Vatican, I'm glad again.
I like that too. Memorize my verses like the Vatican where the Pope is, the Catholic Church. Fun fact for you guys, what is the smallest country in the world? Vatican City. But yeah, talking about his verses, because us as rappers, we break down songs into verses and into hooks, which are choruses, right? So he's talking about memorizing his verses, but also verses like in a Bible passage.
I'm all get mad again. Memorizing verses like the Vatican, I'm glad again. Empty the clip and then do that again. And now we're running around the city on a $1.25. Boy, you better keep your head down if you want to stay alive. People
riding around the city on the $1.25, talking about how much it costs to ride the bus. He's still on the bus, man. He's still cruising, but you got to keep your head down if you want to stay alive, because he's from the other side of those train tracks.
Riding around the city on the $1.25. Boy, you better keep your head down if you want to stay alive. People telling you to stay in your lane, can't even drive. Tell you not to chase your dreams because they chain
Man. Oh, I love those lines. That is soul right there. See, Logic has such an old mind, and he always gives us so much wisdom with his lyrics, right? And these people telling you to stay in your own lane when they can't even drive, right? They don't want you to chase your dreams. They don't want you to succeed because they never succeeded and they never achieved their dreams. Now they're stuck in a box in a 9-to-5.
You to stay in your lane, can't even drive. Tell you not to chase your dreams, cause they chained to a 9-to-5. Bitch, I'm too alive like twins in a womb. Come hither, consume all of my memory.
Too alive like twins in the womb. That was also from the No Pressure freestyle, wasn't it? Yeah, because twins, obviously, there's two of them. They're both alive, but he's also too alive. So two is in T-W-O, but two is in T-O-O as well. Great homophone.
They chained to a 9-to-5, bitch. I'm too alive like twins in a womb. Come hither, consume all of my memories from past and present like two identities. Logic falling off in the vicinity.
My memories from past and present like two identities. Right? There's the past him, there's the present him. It's like two different people, two different identities, like twins as well, two different identities. And shout out to my two twin daughters.
All of my memories from past and present like two identities. Logic falling off is an obscenity. Top five, I better be steadily dogging these bitches like I'm a pedigree. Attain class with no degree. Fuck a GED, EBT, and the HOC. Feeling
obtain class with no degree because he's got class, even though he never actually graduated. And he's dogging him. You know, dog, pedigree. Just so many nice wordplay, man. But still, smooth in the pocket at all times. Logic is never phased.
I'm a pedigree, attain class with no degree. Fuck a GED, EBT, and a HOC.
GED, right? So that's when you don't get your high school diploma. So that's like the alternative for a lot of high school dropouts. And what are the other ones that he said? HOC? That's like housing commission or something. That's for poor housing, right? And then the EBT, right? Hang on.
I'm a pedigree, attain class with no degree. Fuck a GED, EBT, and the HOC. Feeling free.
EBT. That's dealing with welfare as well, isn't it? Yeah, that's definitely dealing with welfare. So he's talked about a situation before, how, you know, he came from Section 8 housing, how he came from the poor area, and he didn't have the same opportunities. And he had to work his ass off to get out of it. And he had to do what he could to stay out of trouble.
Degree, attain class with no degree.
But a lot of these things, you know, happen to those people who are in these impoverished communities. That's what he's saying. Like, fuck all these different things. I don't want any of those. I don't want any of that. I want to overcome my class struggle and my situation. It's a really creative way to put it in a well thought out way.
GED, EBT, and the HOC. Feeling free. Yeah, I'm feeling free, but it costs a fee to be the boss. It costs to be possessions like an apostrophe. It's chemical warfare on the block. Who got
over possessions like an apostrophe, because an apostrophe shows possession of something. But he's over possessions, you know, he's over these monetary things. He stands for something beyond that. Even though his life has been defined by it and trying to overcome it, he's about more than just that.
Be the boss that costs to be. Over possessions like an apostrophe. It's chemical warfare on the block. Who got the rock? A tablespoon of baking soda. Leave you shell shocked. Leave the pusher in a...
Wow. That's real street shit right there. The baking soda in the spoon will leave you shell-shocked. Chemical warfare on the block, right? So shell-shocked happens as a result of war, post-traumatic stress syndrome, right? Being shell-shocked from it. But also, shell-shocked is in the slang, right? Leaving you shell-shocked because people who are crack addicts, when they take the baking soda, right? It creates just like a greater hit. Like, it hits your senses. So he's playing off of that, the baking soda in with it.
Blocking it. The block, who got the rock, a tablespoon of baking soda.
Oh yeah, and rock, crack.
Leave you shell shocked, leave the pusher in a cell block, and his customer in a box. The government got my pops, the government can't be stopped.
Leave the pusher in a cell block. Whoever's selling those drugs ends up in jail, while the customer ends up in a box, because they're dead. They die from overdose.
In a cell block, and his customer in a box. The government got my pops, the government can't be stopped.
And he gets pit fast when he wants to. The government got my pops.
I'm a gladiator. This shit right here more like random thought. It's more like
we interrupt this transmission with a special report.
Yo, and again at the end, that voiceover, that was a shout out to the incredible true story. Oh man, I just wanted that to keep going, but it is an intro, isn't it? So he puts you in this mood and this vibe, and you think we're just gonna carry on this wave, man, and then all of a sudden it's like, nope, get off the ride, we're gonna start a different one now. so smooth though. So smooth and so much soul. This is real hip hop. If you can't appreciate Logic and what he brings, then you're not gonna like my reactions and what I'm doing. I don't know why you've watched it for this long, but come on now. Logic, you did not disappoint, man. I'm very excited to see what else you bring to the table. But this one, this sets the tone and sets the stage for what I hope is going to be a classic album. You are Knox Hill certified. So hope you guys liked today's video. If you did, be sure to smash that like button. Comment down below any other Logic songs you want to see me do, or if there's other artists you want to see me check out. I try to read all of your comments, guys. I respond to them as much as I can. So please keep commenting and keep posting. Also, don't forget to subscribe and notifications on so we can keep growing, keep building the buzz, and keep doing this. I read a stat, guys. 75% of you who watch these videos are not subscribed. What are you doing? If you like the content, you like what I'm doing, please show me some support, hit that sub button. Also, you might have been subscribed, but something happened with YouTube, so please just double check that and make sure that you're still subscribed. Appreciate you as always, guys. This is your reminder to stay safe, to stay positive. If you need anything at all, reach out to me, reach out to this community. You are never, ever alone. I love you guys. It's Knox Hill, and I'll catch you in the next video. I'm out.